Hello, my name is Irina Arshukova, and I would like to present you our work.
Our work is devoted to an assessment of mortality and economic burden due to the regular tobacco usage among the population of the Krasnoyarsk region of the Russian Federation. The territory of Krasnoyarsk region was chosen for the analysis because of the two main reasons. First, the prevalence of smoking in the Krasnoyarsk region is higher than the average rate of smoking in Russia. Approximately 46% of the adult population in the Krasnoyarsk region are active smokers. Second, premature mortality of the working age population leads to a significant burden to the federal budget of the Russian Federation. This is connected with the fact that Krasnoyarsk region is the absolute leader among the other regions of the country in the development of industrial products per capita. The population of the region heavily contributes to the industrial workforce, such as in the chemical and metallurgical industries. Thus, premature mortality in the working age population results in significant gross regional product loss. Therefore, health preservation is not only social, but also an important economic problem. In our work, three main causes of smoking-related deaths were considered: cardiovascular disease, lung cancer, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. And the population of working ages from 20 till 72 years old was investigated. The databases of mortality and population size of the territorial body of state statistics of the Krasnoyarsk region were used as the information sources. The mortality databases contain the numbers of deaths due to the cause of death, gender, and age. Joint application of population-attributable risk and daily method allowed us to estimate demographic and economic burden due to the tobacco-attributable premature mortality in the investigated population. We found that tobacco-related economic burden is at least equal to 2% of the gross regional product of the Krasnoyarsk region in 2013. This amount of losses reflects only the cost of smoking-related premature mortality. However, smoking is associated with the high morbidity, so smoking-related economic burden includes tobacco-associated hospitalization expenses and disability payments. We analyzed three main causes of smoking-related deaths: cardiovascular disease, lung cancer, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. It should be noted that regular tobacco smoking enhances risk of many other diseases. Therefore, additional consideration of these diseases will raise the value of the economic burden. Another additional tobacco costs include the impact of secondhand smoke. So, we can conclude that the reduction in tobacco usage will lead to an increase in life expectancy in the population of working ages, reduce medical fees and disability payments, and decrease tax losses from regional businesses. Collectively, this will significantly reduce the economic burden to the federal budget of the Russian Federation. Therefore, development of programs and incentives for smoking cessation is a priority for prevention of the tobacco use-related deaths and reduction of their impact on the economy of the Russian Federation.